Hello everyone, this is Vincent. I'm the software developer for Image Paint. It is an Adobe Illustrator plugin for laser and CNC router. In this video, I'm going to take an inlay pattern from a good friend of mine, artist Kathy Weiss, and then use Image Paint to come up with this design. After which, I will use my CNC router to cut the wood veneers to create this. I start with a few pieces of wood veneers, label them at the top left corner according to their species names, scan them into JPEG images, and then rename those files the same as the labels. Now, I have to round the corners to match the tool bit I plan to use. To do this, I select the design, specify the job type, which tool to use, and then click the round corners button. Let's zoom in and take a look at how the corners were rounded. It didn't round these corners, and rightly so. And these were rounded in a normal fashion, but these were rounded differently. This is because there are more than two pieces joined at the corner. Here I'm reducing the number of points on all the paths. This will help speed up those CNCs that are too slow in executing larger number of G-code lines. I'm ready to apply images to these paths. By specifying where the scanned images are, Image Paint will bring them in and add them to the Images panel. I like to use the Magic Wand tool to select same color paths and make sure the fill color tolerance value is low. Once the paths are selected, click on an image swatch to apply. In this early stage, I just want to quickly apply different images to all the paths and not worry about where they are on the image. But it is very important to visualize which direction the sunlight comes from. In this case, I assume the light comes from the upper right corner in the scene. For me, I need to see the overall view of the design. With all the woods in place, I need to see how the wood color and grain combination work together as a whole before I can begin to relocate the clipper path on the image in order to achieve the desired texture, shadow, or highlight in the scene. Now I need to add more images to the panel. I can specify where they are as before or simply drag them into Illustrator. The new images will be added to the bottom of the panel. Use the tonal variations in the wood to render the shadows and highlights, instead of cutting a shape into many shapes. For example, the sky in this design was separated into three pieces. I merged them into one piece and used this poplar species to render the cloud. Another example. This ash olive species, the natural stripes in it give the illusion of ocean waves. And this pimento wood burr, how it can make the mountain look so stunning with only two shapes at this location. I use the text tool to add her name at the bottom right. Select the font, resize it as small as the CNC can handle. I then expand the text to regular paths. Review the background path, select it along with the text, and punch the text through with the Pathfinder tool. Now I have to round the resulting text to fit the tool diameter of 0.02 inches. I select both the text and the background, click the rounding corner button. I'm ready to create the tool paths for the design. But before I do, I need to explain how the toolpath engine works. This is the Smart G-Code panel in normal display mode. To create the toolpaths to cut this piece of wood, I select it and then click on the Create Toolpath button. Let's do that again, but this time with the panel fully expanded to show all CNC parameters. Notice, as I select the image, these parameters will change to show the CNC settings for that wood category. Now, all I have to do is to click the Create Toolpath button. With Image Paint, this process is automated because it contains a material database that is categorized into material categories. It has a preset database where each preset contains all necessary settings to create the toolpaths. Since a material can be linked to a preset, all you have to do is to select the material, The G-code panel will display everything it needs to create the toolpaths for that material. Now for creating the pocket. I need to create another artboard dedicated to making the pocket. The size of this artboard doesn't have to be the same as the CNC, so I'm resizing it to the size of the wooden plaque. Holding down the Alt key, I click and drag the background path to the new artboard. Click the artboard to make it active and center it. Next, I release compound path and delete the outer path. To create the toolpaths for the ellipse, I select the material category similar to the plaque, select preset common veneer pocketing, select artboard 15 to specify which artboard representing the CNC. Select the tools I like to use and click on the Create Toolpath button. Before creating the pockets for the text, I have to selectively make compound path to properly form the A, S, and E letters. I select the text, select tool number 2, and then click on the Create Toolpath button. I'm ready to create the G-code files for the pockets. To do this, I select artboard 15 to specify where the toolpaths are, select the post-processor for my CNC, specify where to store the file, enter the file name, and click on the Create G-code button. To create the G-code files for cutting the veneers, I review the image by double-clicking on the image watch. Select the image to show its name, copy the name, paste it into the file name area, and click on the Create G-code button. Using the same procedure, I continue to create the G-code files for the other sheets of wood veneers. To view the G-code files, on the G-code panel, I click the file label located to the left of the file name. Here I'm using a low-tack double-sided tapes and applying them to the back of the wood veneer. It is important that the tape is applied in the direction of the wood grain so that when it is removed, the veneer does not tear. This part of the video is running at normal speed. The CNC feed rate is set in the G-code file and is running at 22 inches per minute. I Z0 the tool bit on top of the tape to allow the tool to cut through the veneer, but not the tape. This will prevent the tool bit from clogging up and also to make it easier for me to remove the cut pieces later on. I have found that it is easier to remove the cut pieces first before removing the whole sheet from the sacrificial board. The G-code file I generated earlier contained automatic tool change information. So the CNC, after carving out the text, it went to the tool holder and picked up a different tool to carve out the ellipse. The same ATC action is also contained in the G-code file when it created this pocket. Once all the veneers have been cut, I update the images to show the cut areas. First, I review the cutter image selected and click the image update button. At this point, the updated images will not be visible. I'm repeating this procedure for the other cutter images. When all images have been updated, I need to close all documents and reopen the Lighthouse document to see the updated images. As you can see, there are visible gaps between the pieces. This is due to the inherent backlash of my CNC. In any case, these gaps must be filled to prevent the glue from penetrating the remaining gaps. To do this, I use wood paste of various colors and apply them on the backside of the veneers. Here is the finished piece. The left picture is the simulation image done in Image Paint. Compared to the actual piece, I think Image Paint did a great job of aligning the wood grains and texture on the actual piece to match the simulation. I hope you have learned something from this video. If you like the video, please click the like button and subscribe to my channel. Also, don't forget to leave your comments below. I love to hear from you. Until the next video, goodbye and have fun with your next CNC project.